Hello everyone, this is the Huawei Watch GT2e. You might have heard of it, but you might have heard of the Huawei Watch GT2. And they are almost the same. Well, not the same watch face, but they're almost the same. So what's the difference? Well, this one was launched a few weeks ago, I think, with the P40 Pro, and this one was launched a few months ago with the Mate 30 Pro. And as I was looking through the specs, there aren't any big differences between these two watches, unless you look very closely. So this is the watch I've been wearing for about 4 or 5 months. It works very well even in a sporty outfit with a t-shirt or with a dress suit. Yes, you might want to change the strap with the leather one. You can change it very easily. But hey, I like it. I like it because of the battery life, and this is essential in a smartwatch. This one has also a very good battery life. Let's see the differences after a small unboxing. So, inside the box you're going to find the watch right here and some manuals. I already know this one, so I know how it works. And right here you're going to find the USB-C cable and the charging pad. No, it's not wireless, but you can always carry it with you in your backpack and use a normal USB-C cable. You can also charge it from your laptop. It takes about 1 hour, 1.5 hours to go to full charge, and that's only 2 times a month. Because yes, the same watch has the same battery that keeps it up all day and all night for about 14 days. Unless you're too activity freak, a jogger, you like to climb mountains and use the GPS, that's going to come down to a few days, I think. So let's see the differences. First difference is that this watch can lay flat on the table because the straps are actually very mobile, up and down. This one doesn't stay flat on the table because it's more sport orientated. And in every sport activity, you want a watch to stay snug and fit. That's because you want better and more accurate recordings. So in terms of size and weight, there is almost none. A mere 2 grams extra for the Watch GT2e, but 0.9 inches for the screen. I mean, I cannot actually see the difference. They're almost the same size in screen. Yes, the bezel is a little bit bigger, and as you can see, the buttons are a lot flatter. That's because when you're wearing this kind of watch, in any sport activity, there is a chance you might hurt your hand. Because if you push it like this, the buttons are going to hurt your hand right here. Like me. This is from my watch because I was wearing it. Doing some, I don't know, I think I was unboxing some stuff. Anyways, so these are the differences in size and width. Almost nothing. The battery is almost the same, 455 milliamp hour. That's going to keep the watch awake for about 14 days. What's actually the difference between those two? Well, there are some small differences. This one is also coming in a 42 millimeter version. This is the 46. And the 42 millimeter version actually doesn't have some features. As you can see right here on the bottom, the GT2 has a speaker and also has a microphone. You can use it to talk to some people with via Bluetooth. The GT2e doesn't have those features because they wanted to, I don't know, make it a little sport orientated, and they thought you won't need it. Actually, that's a very good feature that I miss having, because I wouldn't switch to this one just because of that feature. I like the feature of talking on my wrist because I always misplace my phone, especially when I'm at work, and it's very useful when I'm driving. I just hold my hand like this or keep it on the wheel and keep talking, even though, yeah, I know you have car Bluetooth and so on and so forth. Right now, those watches actually act almost the same. In a few weeks, the GT2e is going to receive an update to have an SpO2 meter. That's going to measure the oxygen in your blood. Well, actually, it's going to estimate it after 1 week or so of wearing, after it learns your pattern of moving and exercising. Amongst other things, yes, it can measure your heart rate, has the exactly same sensor, the exact operating system, with some more special faces, let's say. There are a few faces that are not available for the GT2, and I don't think you're going to be able to get them anytime soon on the GT2. On the back, we see the same sensors, but there's a small difference in construction. I don't know why, I haven't checked, but they say this one is a little more resistant. Although I haven't had any problems with the GT2, as you can see, the screen is almost intact, and I personally don't care how I use my watch. I actually used it last night when I was replanting some plants in some other pots, and no scratches at all. I wear this almost 24/7. I only take it out in the shower. Yes, it's water resistant, both are down to 50 meters, but soap and salty water is not so good for electronics, so that's why I'm taking it off while I'm taking a shower. I don't take it off while I wash my hands, and yes, I do wash them a lot. I had to pick a little at the specs. So, they both have 1.39-inch AMOLED screen. It has GPS, GLONASS. This one has also Galileo, that's the European version. The Kirin A1 chipset, 32 megabytes of RAM and 4 gigabytes of storage. Yes, you can transfer music from your smartphone to your watch, and it's a bit of a pain in the ass because it only works on Android. For the app, you're going to use the Huawei Health app, and this is the results with my watch. I actually had this one worn by a colleague for about 2 weeks, and we have the same results. As you can see here, SpO2 is not available for me. I also do my sleep tracking. Oh, that's a feature that this watch doesn't have, at least not right now. But if they're going to introduce SpO2 monitoring, I think they're going to be able to set an update for the sleep tracking. I don't know, I hope so, because you could sleep with this on your hand. It's very comfortable, it's very not that heavy, it's almost 42 or 43 grams, so you might be able to sleep with this on your hand. You're going to benefit from all of the watch functions only on Android. The iOS version, I think, is missing the sleep tracking and some, yeah, the stress meter. It's not available on Android right now. My watch also has 5%, I gotta charge it. It's gonna take about 1.5 hours. And you can add music from here. You can manage music, you can control phone music, but only the playlist that's playing on your smartphone right now, not from a third party like Spotify. Not right now. There's going to be an update for both of them, and I hope that works very good. So basically, you just have to select music and set add to watch from your smartphone. That's because it has Bluetooth and also can connect with a pair of headphones, the Huawei FreeBuds 3. That's a good option. And you can leave your phone at home while you work out. That's a good idea because you don't want to, let's say, be interrupted while you're working out by messages, text, or any other stuff. You can just take your watch and a pair of headphones and be on with it. So, the exercises, yes, there are a lot, and there's a lot of options. On the smartphone, you're going to see just a few of them. And like the GT2, you're going to be able to set any kind of workout and edit them. Let's say a pool swim or indoor cycle. You're going to set a goal, a reminder, and that's up to you. You might like this version because it's a little bit more stylish, but if you go for the sporty one, I won't judge you, and no one will. What you have to keep in mind is that this one doesn't have voice calling on Bluetooth, and that's pretty much it. And yes, it's going to be a little bit cheaper than the GT2, and yes, I think it's going to come with a smart scale. There was an offer on Amazon a few days ago, so go see if you can catch it. If you ask me, I wouldn't know which one to choose. They both do almost the same things, minus the voice calling feature for the GT2e, so I would choose by design. Which one do you like most? The sportier version or the more classical version? It's up to you. You can always change the strap bands on the GT2e. you can change the straps on the GT2 as well, but you might need some special straps so it fits very good over here. And that's pretty much it. Same battery life, same water resistance, they do almost the same thing. One of them is newer and more sportish oriented. That's about it. So this is the Huawei Watch GT2e. This is my short review after using it for a few days, along with the older brother, the GT2. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like this video, well, YouTube is the only platform I know where you can give a thumbs down. But just think about it. It's just a watch. Why didn't you like this video? Leave a comment down below. What would you choose and why? And I'm going to see you in the next one. Cheers.